Hello everyone, this is Dr. Sam and today we will study fetal stomach ultrasound appearances. The stomach can be visualized around 13 to 14 weeks. It is usually anechoic because it is fluid filled and has various shapes and sizes. We can see the stomach at the level in which we see the umbilical vein. Here you can see the umbilical vein and over here you can see the stomach. This is a good level to locate the stomach. Here are more transverse views of the stomach. Here they have different shape and a different size as compared to the previous images. The filling of the stomach depends on the swallowing of amniotic fluid by the fetus. Here we can see the umbilical vein and here is the stomach and here is the spine, hyperechoic with shadowing. A gastric pseudomass occurs when the fetus swallows skin cells, umbilical cord parts or even blood, which may resemble a stomach mass. But it is not a stomach mass. These are just swallowed materials which look like a mass or a tumor. Here is a longitudinal view of the stomach. It appears elongated. And here is the fetal spine. The stomach is simply fluid filled and there is no swallowed material. And over here we have the gastric pseudomass, which we see in longitudinal view due to swallowed materials such as skin cells or blood or parts of the umbilical cord. And here is the fetal spine. Esophageal atresia is a birth defect in which the esophagus does not develop properly, which leads to obstruction at the level of the esophagus. Now, due to this obstruction, the stomach does not fill with amniotic fluid. That is why we may not even see the stomach. Usually this condition is associated with polyhydramnios because of improper swallowing of amniotic fluid. There is a large accumulation of amniotic fluid around the fetus. In this image we see polyhydramnios. There is a large accumulation of amniotic fluid due to improper swallowing. The stomach here is appearing small. This is due to gastric secretions. These are stomach's own secretions. That is why it is appearing small. This setting can occur in esophageal atresia. We cannot see a normal fluid-filled duodenum on ultrasound. Usually it is not visible. Only when it is dilated, it is visible. Now this similar condition can also occur with duodenum. In duodenal atresia, part of the duodenum does not develop properly. This leads to dilatation of both the duodenum and the stomach. Here we see two dilated structures. One is the stomach and this one is the duodenum. The double bubble sign is the name given to this appearance in which the stomach and the duodenum both are dilated. They appear as two bubbles, two dilated anechoic structures. This is a sign of duodenal atresia. Here is a coronal view of a double bubble sign. The stomach and the duodenum both are dilated in the setting of duodenal atresia. An enteric duplication cyst may resemble a double bubble sign or duodenal atresia, but there is one distinguishing feature, that is the stomach will not connect with the cyst, whereas it will connect with the duodenum, and also the cyst may be teardrop shaped. In congenital diaphragmatic hernia, there is a defect in the diaphragm which will allow abdominal organs to protrude through this defect and enter the chest cavity. Mostly the stomach is seen protruding through this defect, and here you can see in this coronal view the stomach is herniating through this diaphragmatic defect. In this image we can see the stomach in the thoracic cavity. The heart is displaced towards the right side because of herniation of the stomach. The stomach is no longer seen in the abdomen. Seeing the stomach in the thorax is a strong sign of congenital diaphragmatic herniation. Thank you so much for watching. Please subscribe and stay tuned for more imaging videos.